Hello students, this is Shweta Roy. This video is for Chapter 2, Economics, Part 2, People as Resource. In this video, we are going to discuss the topic, Economic Activities by Men and Women. Here we have the topic economic activities by men and women. So we already discussed about Vilas and Sakal, and we discussed that Vilas and Sakal, how they were engaged in the different activities and what was their growth. So like them, people have been engaged in various activities. Like you saw that Vilas, he sold fish, and Sakal got a job in the firm. So like this, people do various activities, and these various activities have been classified into three main sectors. Those are primary, secondary, and tertiary. So in primary sector, there is agriculture, forestry, animal husbandry, fishing, poultry farming, mining, and quarrying. Now, these all comes in the primary sector. If you talk about secondary sector, we have manufacturing. Then comes tertiary sector. In tertiary sector, we have trade, transport, communication, banking, education, health, tourism, services, insurance, etc. These all are in tertiary sector. Now, whatever activities done in this sector result in the production of goods and services. And like this, if you see, these activities add value to the national income. And they are called economic activities. Because all these activities, when it is performed, they will add some value. Right? There will be some income. And like this, they are adding to national income. And because of that, they are called economic activities. Now, economic activities have two parts. Market activities and non-market activities. So, if you talk about market activities, there you will find whatever activities performed for pay or profit, that is under market activities. Like you have production of goods or services, government services, this all comes in the market activities. Now, if you talk about non-market activities, they are production for self-consumption. Here also you can see a picture, and there is a question. Based on the picture, can you classify these activities into three sectors? Three sectors means primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. So, you need to do this activity. We were discussing about non-market activities. So, non-market activities are for self-consumption. Now, here you have an activity. Say whether these activities are economic or non-economic activities. Vilas sells fish in the village market. Vilas cooks food for his family. Sakal works in the private firm. Sakal looks after his younger brother and sister. So you need to categorize these four into non-economic activities and economic activities. Now, there is a division of labor between men and women in the family. That is due to historical and cultural reasons. Now, women, what they generally do? They generally look after domestic chores, and men, they work in the fields. It is divided like this. Now, Shakal's mother, Sheila, she used to cook food, clean utensils, wash clothes, clean the house, and look after her children. Now, Shakal's father, Bhuta, he used to cultivate the field and sells the whatever produce is there in the market and earn money for the family. Now, if you see, Sheila is not paid for the services. Whatever services she is doing for her family, that is not payable. That she is not paid for that. But Bhuta, whatever work he is doing, he is earning money with that, which he is spending on his family. So, whatever services women are doing, they are not paid for that. Whatever services they are doing in the family, that is not paid. So the household work, whatever is done by the woman, that is not recognized in the national income. Now you have Geeta, who is mother of Vilas. She used to earn money by selling fish. So in this case, woman is paid. She is paid. Whatever work she is doing, she is paid for that. So if you see, when they are working at home, they are not paid. But when they are entering the labor market, they are earning money. Also, the earning depends on the basis of education and skill, as we have seen in the case of Vilas and Sakal. So, in that case, we see that education actually helps the individual to make better use of the economic opportunity. So, if you have good education, if you have good skills, you can earn more. But if you see, the most of the women, they does not have higher education, that kind of education. So what happens? They have low education as well as low skill formation. So they earn less, they are paid less. Also, their job is not secure. So if you see, they have low education and they have low skill formation, they will work in the field which is not secured. Also, there will be low wages and they will not get the benefits like maternity leave, child care. This kind of facilities they will not get in that environment. But if women are highly educated, their skills formation is good, they are paid good. And because of this, the most of the women are attracted towards teaching and medical profession. In this case, what happens? they get the facilities. Whatever facilities are there for women, they will get that. Also, the women are now entering in the administrative and other services like scientific and technological competence is there in the sectors, that kind of sectors they are entering these days. Now we will discuss about quality of population. So quality of population depends on the literacy rate, health of a person, skill formation. And this quality of population decides the growth rate of the country. Literate and healthy population are an asset. As we have already discussed, that if a country is investing on education and health, their people resource will be an asset for them. In this we have education. So Sucker's education, which he has done in his initial years, actually bore him. He was bored of that, but it was fruitful in the later years because he got good job and good salary. So here the education was an important input for the growth of Sakal. And with this, he got new opportunities. And like this, he developed the value of his life. And education not only enhances the human, it also contributes towards the growth of society. It enhances national income, cultural richness, and it increases the efficiency of governance. So, there is a provision made for providing universal access, retention, and quality in elementary education, with a special emphasis on girls. Also, there are establishment of some schools like Navodaya Vidyalaya in each district. Also, vocational streams have been developed. Now the plan outlay on education has increased from rupees 151 crore in the first plan to rupees 3,766.90 crore in the 11th plan. So the investment in education is also happening. It is increasing. Now the expenditure on education as a percentage of GDP rose from 0.64%, which was in 1951 to 1952, to 3.0% in 2015 to 2016. And it was stagnant around 3% from past few years. So you can see the investment in education is also increasing. Now we have some of the questions. You have a graph here. You need to study this graph and you have to answer some of the questions. Has the literacy rates of the population increased since 1951? In which year India has the highest literacy rate? Why literacy rate is high among the males of India? Why are women less educated than men? How would you calculate literacy rate in India? What is your projection about India's literacy rate in 2020? So, these are some of the questions which you need to answer. So, do this activity. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.